What's up everyone, Brisbike here. Beautiful sunny day in Queensland. As you can see, it's about 7 o'clock in the morning. Waiting for some mates, I'm gonna go for a ride. Heading down over the border to New South Wales, gonna go up through Lyons Road, follows like the train track and up around the mountain down and then to Kyogle, through to Moolumbah and probably to Currumbin, Iron Resin Garage for some nice burgers. So come along for the ride, should be fun. It's great weather. Supposed to be a storm later on today. But yeah, the sun's pretty bright. And we'll take the CVO ST for a ride. Cool's coming up. There she is. All covered up. Got my Bell helmet on charge. Got the Cardo Pack Talk Pro ready to go. A few jokes and laughing with the boys and we head off. But I'll have to take this cover off. It's gonna be warm. I think I'll just wear a t-shirt and my arm sleeves. I know it's probably not the safest option, but I think it's gonna be pretty hot otherwise. There we go. Ready to rock and roll. Just had its first service the other week and I changed the bar setup, so I got the thrashing 6.5 inch pullback with the high bend bars. I did add a 1 inch spacer down, so it's actually like 7.5 inch with the high bend bars, and I put on there grips which are small and comfortable, moto style. Really like the positioning of the bars, just makes my back a bit straighter and yeah, really good. Soft towel standard. Just gonna head off now, meet up with some of the boys at the servo, and then off we go for our trip. Let's go. Trip today. Here at this servo we got 91 unleaded, there's 98. Normally I try and use 95 because the dealership said 95, similar to what they got in their states, which is like your 91 in the states, so 98 is probably a bit more than what it needs, but I'll throw that in today. I'd rather use that than our 91, but 95 is normally what I go for, just because they said, yeah, similar to 91 in the states. There's an owl over there waiting for us. Let's top this bike up. Dale's breakout battery. I've got a couple of batteries, but one of them's
already recorded.
Yeah, mate. There we go. We'll have a look at Dale's breakout. Was it 22 breakout, I think, or 21? It's gonna get bars on it soon. So the freedom pipes. Bag on the side, put his bits on. It's the 114, so it was the last before the 117s came out in the breakout. Thank you. just got off that dirt road detour. Now we're on some bitumen again, but the bikes are filthy. Look at the CVO ST, mate. Dust. Gonna need a good bath when he gets home. All over Dale. He was at the back, so he was copping everyone's dust. The old breakout. So yeah, detour, had to go down a dirt road. Not ideal, but you gotta do what you gotta do. We'll keep going through to Kyogle and maybe have a drink or something. Look at this countryside, green as, beautiful. Lovely day. Weather's perfect. Get home this afternoon, give the bike a bit of a scrub. But couldn't ask for a better day for it. Feel good, mate? Car coming. Peter's food hall, grab something, and we'll head off to Moolumba. End up at Corumban for lunch at Iron Resin Garage.
Boys are stopping at some more fuel, top it up. Let's go.
Thank you.
Resin Garage. Go get a nice feed. Iron Resin.
Iron and Resin Garage. Got a shop in here that sells apparel and helmets and gloves and some cool bikes all lined up. Old Road King. There's stuff in there. Go check that out later. Cool paint job. All the nice burgers and bikes and stuff. Sorry, mate. You're all right. Yeah, it's cool, eh? At least you got some air on it.
Not much.
That was a good ride, fellas, eh?
Yeah.
Except for the dirt road, a bit of the detour.
Yeah, that's it, eh?
Pull up here now, wait, get a feed. I'm just getting a cheeseburger, but what'd you get?
I've got
Beachmont barbecue chicken. Oh, I should have went somewhere. But I don't know, I wasn't feeling like too much. But no, we'll check it out when they bring it out, and then go check out that apparel shop in there, have a look what they got in there, eh?
Yeah.
But no, there's some good weather and good twisties, a few potholes and a few bumps, like sent you out of the seat a couple of times.
Good days.
Great day. Look forward to doing it more.
Did you pull the
seat? Yeah. Oh well, have to smash this. Enjoy, boys. We'll hit the road. Head home from here. So I won't be filming much after this. Eat this and then head on home. Just got home, tired now, been a big day, been probably out on the road for 7 or 8 hours, probably about 6 hours riding, I don't know, 400 or 500 kilometres, but the bike's filthy, so I'm going to have to let it cool down and give it a nice scrub, wash it down. There's dust all over it since we had to go down that dirt road from that detour, but it was all good. As long as no one laid their bikes down or had punctures, we all did all right, so... But yeah, the bikes are all dirty, so spewing about that, but hey, that's it. All about having fun and getting out there. So here it is. It's not too bad. This is dust all over it, everywhere. This is dust on it. So I'll give her a good bath and should come up pretty good. Since I've had a ceramic coat, it should all come off pretty easy. What about 400 or 500 k's on today, so at about 2,200 or 300 k's on this bike, so it's still fairly new. Keen to keep getting out with all the boys. It was fun today, weather was perfect. Bit of a storm, looks like it's starting to brew up for this afternoon, so I might even put the bike away and wash it tomorrow. But yeah, the bike was going really well, handling well, scrubbing on those few of those corners. Gave the camera to Damo, see if he gets a better angle, so we'll see how it all turns out. Bike's a beast, still loving it. I was pretty much cruising around in sport mode most of the time. Seat, still unsure, was a little bit sore on the way home after sitting like 4 or 5 hours on that. I think it's still either got a break in or, but I'm definitely thinking of changing the floorboards to something a bit longer. They're okay, but I just like a little bit more to be able to move my feet around into better positions, stretch out a bit, since it's hard to stretch your feet around the massive intake there, so you can just get the edge of the crash bar. But yeah, I might just change to the longer floorboard, see what I can find, whether I go with the same one or a thrashing, and even found some cheaper ones at Amazon, not sure on the quality of those, but might just give one of those a try first and see how they are. But yeah, no, so unfortunately needs a good bath. Normally I just give it a bit of a waterless spray wax thing I've got and then wipe it down with the microfiber, but no, I've got to get the hose out and sponge and put a bit of effort in for once. But yeah, good fun. I'll catch us next time. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I'll put more content out on the CVO ST, but won't be that regular as I'm probably lazy these days, and let all the people with all the charisma do all the YouTube. There's plenty of YouTubers out there making good content, but I'll throw some up every now and again. Cheers, catch you later.